Make your videos on. Put your videos on.
Yes. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Boker to.
Shalom.
Now it is actually it is Soharto.
Shalom.
Soharto.
Once again, Soharto. Soharto means good afternoon. Oh, everybody say after me. Soharto.
Soharto.
Spelling is T-S-O-H-A-R. Sohar. Soha means afternoon and to means good. May I know who has joined through that OnePlus device? Please rename yourself. वन प्लस डिवाइस मध्ये कोणी लॉग इन केले ते तुमचं नाव सांगाल का
जस्ट 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 अ मिनिट आय रीनेम रीनेम माय सेल्फ जस्ट अ मिनिट
गुड आफ्टरनून
ओके सो Today, we are going to see once again from where we left.
Yes.
Let's say this first word again. Say after me. Aleph.
Aleph.
Say after me. Aleph. Everyone, unmute yourself. Put your videos on and be attentive. Say after me. Aleph.
Aleph.
Aleph. Aleph. Aleph is the first letter of the Hebrew alphabet. Hebrew alphabet matla Aleph jo hai ye first letter hai. It represents head of an ox. Marathi madhe mhanlo tar bailache doke. It represents strength and power, samarthya ani shakti to learn and to teach, shikne kiwa shikone and to produce thousand. These are the meaning of Aleph. I think we have seen it in Zion, na?
Seven letters.
Okay. We'll just take revision. This is the Aleph in pictograph language. Then under development, it became Katav Ashurit. They adopted the Aramaic script. And now in modern Hebrew, this Aleph is written like this. Aleph is a silent letter. Everybody say after me. Aleph is a silent letter.
Aleph
is a silent letter. Aleph is a mukh akshar hai. Mukh. मुख बोलो तो न बोलने वाला एंड आलेफ रिप्रेजेंट्स गॉड आलेफ हा देवाचं प्रतिनिधित्व करतो गॉड हॅज क्रिएटेड एव्हरीथिंग बट ऑल्दो हिज प्रेझेन्स इज सायलेंट थ्रू आउट द युनिवर्स सो आलेफ रिप्रेझेंट्स गॉड स्ट्रेंथ अँड पॉवर नेक्स्ट इज बेथवेथ
बेथवेथ
बेथवेथ नाउ कॅन यू टेल मी विच इज बेथ अँड विच इज वेथ Pastor Solomon?
Yeah. That is without dot, it is Beth. Without dot, it is Beth.
Without?
With dot.
With dot, it is?
Dalit.
Dalit.
No, so...
With dot is Beth and without dot...
Without Beth, that's for you.
No, you are confusing. With dot, say it is Beth.
Beth, yeah. Yeah,
with dot, it is Beth.
Beth.
And
Beth.
Without dot, it is Beth.
Beth. Oh, yes.
Brother, without dot means V.
Yeah, Beth. Without dot means Beth, V.
Beth.
Okay.
Yeah.
Without V. Without V. Okay.
It is V. Its transliteration okay. is V. V in wine. We in victory, not in victory, you can say, yeah, we in victory, we in van.
So with dot it is Beth and without dot it is with.
Yeah, correct. Okay. With dot. And that dot is called?
Nagish.
Dagesh.
Yes.
Dot is called Dagesh. So this is the second letter of the Hebrew alphabet. First we have seen is Aleph and second is Beth.
Beth.
Yes.
Third is, say after me, Gimel.
Gimel.
It gets sounds jingle, G. It gives G sound, that is G. Then Dalit.
Dalit
gives D sound in door. D sound in door. See, in pictograph, it is the picture is like a door. Then in Katha Vavri, it becomes like Delta, capital Greek letter, Delta.
Delta.
Similarly, this Latin Vulgate, that is Latin letter Aleph, is Alpha. The Greek alphabet is derived Alpha. Then this from Beth, it is derived Beta.
Beta.
Yeah. And from Dalit, it is Delta.
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 It gives D sound. D in door. Then fifth alphabet is Hey.
Hey.
Alphabet is Hey. Hey gives H sound in Hey. H sound. Hey means behold. Paha. Arms raise. Everybody, arms raise. Hey means arms raised. Man, see, then pictograph language, you can see a man is saying, behold what I'm doing. I'm praising God. I'm raising my hands up and praising God. So, hey. Hey means low, behold. And it is H in hey. And sixth alphabet, everybody say, wow.
Wow.
Wow. Wow. And it is really a wonderful wow alphabet. This wow sound you will find everywhere. Everywhere. God has put this miraculously in every animal. For example, dog also. Wow, wow. So everywhere you will see this wow sound.
Wow.
If in Hebrew alphabet, wow has been removed. In spiritual sense, I'm talking now. If wow has been removed, then no... there will be no salvation. जर तारण तारणाचा हा शब्द आहे वाव हा जर काढला तर तारण कदापि शक्य नाही. बिकॉज वाव रिप्रेझेंट द टेंट पेक. टेंट पेक मीन्स नेल ऑफ इरेक्टिंग द टेंट. तुम्हाला माहिती आहे का की निवास मंडप जे असायचे त्याचे जो पडदा म्हणजे वरचं जे तंबू असायचे ते जमिनीमध्ये ठोकण्याकरता हे निवास मंडपाचे खिळे म्हणजे वाव. So this tent peg is called the nail of the erecting tabernacle. Tabernacle has to be erected by this wow. And actually in modern Hebrew, its transliteration is V. V in victory. That is VH sound. Apan mhanto na Marathi bhashemadhye. Vala ha. V. V hota na.
Yeah.
Modern Hebrew madhe ya wow se translation V hota. Parantu apan classical, we are learning classical biblical Hebrew. And its transliteration is W, that is work.
Work.
Work in way. W in way. So remember, for because we are learning some modern Hebrew songs and there are so many script available in modern Hebrew. That's why I have shown you this V in wine. But actually, you have to remember that the correct transliteration is W in way. Work. Way matlab work.
Work.
Yes, anyone have any doubt?
No.
No.
So it represents the cross, it symbolizes the cross of Yeshua, Jesus. Now you are saying that picture at down. Picture tumhala diste ka khali?
Yes.
Yeah.
Can you imagine what it represents? The man,
good Samaritan. Yes.
No. It is actually Sisera, and this is Jael. and this this Sisera when he was fleeing. So this child, she came and she hid her. She hid him in his house. Then tine tichya gharamadhye tyala lapun thevla. And when he was in deep sleep, he took that hammer and nail, which represents the cross of Christ or tent peg, and he put that nail into his ears.
Yes.
And you know what happened there.
Yes.
So तुम्हाला एक यायलची गोष्ट माहित होत की त्या तो जो सिसरा होता त्याने तिला पिण्यासाठी पाणी मागितलं, तिने दूध दिलं आणि तो ज्यावेळेस गाढ झोपेमध्ये होता तिने तो हातोडा घेतला, नेल जो रिप्रेझेंट वाव तो घेतला, त्याच्या कानशिलेमध्ये असं ठोकलं की ती आरपार गेली. सो स्पिरिच्युअली दिस सिसरा रिप्रेझेंट एनिमी ऑफ चर्च. सैतान हा सिसराचं प्रतिनिधित्व करतो. अँड दिस जायल रिप्रेझेंट ऑर दॅट हॅमर इन हर हँड रिप्रेझेंट द वर्ड ऑफ गॉड, देवाचं वचन आपण हातोडा आपण म्हणू शकतो. अँड दिस नेल रिप्रेझेंट द क्रॉस ऑफ क्राइस्ट. एनिमी ओनली फियर्स द क्रॉस. शत्रू सैतान फक्त एकाच गोष्टीला घाबरतो आणि तो म्हणजे येशूचा वधस्तंभ, कारण वधस्तंभाच्या द्वारेच विक्ट्री आहे. इफ यू रिमूव्ह दिस वाव द सॅल्वेशन, बिकॉज थ्रू आउट द होल टेस्टमेंट गॉड वॉज ईगर वेटिंग फॉर हिज सॅल्वेशन टू बी रिव्हील टू हिज पीपल. अँड दिस रिप्रेझेंट दिस पिक्चर इज द थ्रू द सॅल्वेशन, ओनली थ्रू बिकॉज ऑफ द क्रॉस ऑफ क्राइस्ट वी गॉट विक्ट्री, नथिंग एल्स. Because of our righteousness or because of any work that we did? No, not because of that. Only through the cross of Christ we got the salvation. Aplo taran he pakta tya vadasthambacha dwarech zalele aahe, baki kashane zalele nahi. He te chitra disto tyachyamadhye detail mi janar nahi. So wow is the tent peg and W in way. And till here we have seen seventh alphabet is
Zion.
Zion. Zion, it gives Z sound in zebra. It gives Z sound in zebra. Okay. So today we are going to see eighth alphabet. Say after me. Khet.
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 Now when you are saying Khet, first of all remember that Khet is a strong guttural letter. Khet is a strong guttural letter. Guttural letter. Guttural letter means a letter of the throat. When you are pronouncing this throat, this khet letter, that pronunciation should come out of throat. So, as if you are clearing the throat. Khet.
Khet.
Khet. So, yeah, it should come out of the throat. Khet. Khet.
Khet.
Yeah, khet.
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 Khet. Say after me again. Khet.
Khet.
Okay, only this letter is somehow difficult to pronounce. We are not used to very familiar with this letter. बाकीचे लेटर आपण बोलू शकतो, पण हे लेटर आपण आपल्याला सवय नसते. So when you do the gargling and when that sound comes, when we are doing, so that sound actually it is producing. You have to practice that gargling so that you may get that habit of that sound, that we may know the correct accent of this Hebrew sound khet, because this khet sound every now and then they pronounce, and when they pronounce this sound it is very different than our Indian or any other pronunciation. So this khet should come khet. It should come from throat. Khet.
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 The meaning of khet is fenced in, destroy. It also means grace, separation, tent wall. That's artha hai, kumpan, destroy, manje nasht karne, krupa, hadhe khil artha hai, separation, vegle karne, ani tambuchi bhint. Now it gives kh sound, that ch sound in bark. Bark. मराठीमध्ये त्या बाराखडीमध्ये तुम्हाला माहिती आहे की क ख दॅट ख साऊंड इट गिव्स ख ख
ख
बाक बाक
बाक
बाक देन नेक्स्ट अल्फाबेट इज टेथ
टेथ
सेप्टमी टेथ actually this shape of teeth is like a spiral spiral and actually the teeth means serpent teeth mhanje kay tar sap teeth means serpent so the meaning is also spin tirki knot gut vortex or spiral bhaura kiwa serpil and actually the meaning of this teeth is serpent सरपंच पिक्चोग्राफ लैंग्वेज मध्ये बघा क्रॉस दैट पुली आहे बघा ती एंड इट्स ट्रांसलिटरेशन इज टी इन टाइम ट ट टी इन टाइम then 10th alphabet is yod say after me yod
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 y-o-d-h yod
yod
yod yod yod is the 10th alphabet it is 10th alphabet and see in pictograph it represents the r apla jo bahu jo tasa chitra hai bagayach जो हाथ बाहू जो है त्याचा छिद्र एक्चुअली द यार्ड मीन्स हैंड ओनली द मीनिंग इज हैंड सो एक्चुअली योद मीन्स हैंड एंड इट रिप्रेजेंट्स अ बिग पिक्चरग्राफ बट इवेंचुअली इट बिकेम्स अ वेरी स्मॉल अल्फाबेट तो एकदम छोटा अल्फाबेट झाला पहिले तसा नव्हता नाउ आउट ऑफ 22 अल्फाबेट दिस योद इज अ व्हेरी स्मॉलेस्ट अल्फाबेट आउट ऑफ दिस 22 अल्फाबेट योद हा सगळ्यात छोटा अल्फाबेट योद रिप्रेझेंट्स हँड पॉवर माइट हात ऊर्जा किंवा शक्ती इट ऑल्सो रिप्रेझेंट्स क्लोज्ड हँड
क्लोज्ड हँड
closed hand band hat then 10th alphabet is kaf kaf manje this portion hataacha panja that represents kaf
10th or 11
sorry 11 now numeric value of yod is 10 whereas numeric value of kaf is 20 ata tese numeric value baka 10 nantar 11 hot nahi tar 20 hote
oh 20
hebrew madhe sagla multiplication madhe chalto so here with dot it is clear k in kite mana k in kite
k in kite
but without dot this letter is like same pronunciation as khet that kh sound in bak
kh
bak
yeah.
bak
bak
that same sound same it gives the same sound in bak k sound now you see the pictographic language see the palm of an hand palm of a hand can you see there
ali
baka palm of hand so this cup means palm or panja so with dot it is clear K in kite. Without dot, it is a kh sound in bark. And when it is written at the end of the word, it is written in a final form. हा जो दिसतोय माझ्या राईट साईडला दिस राईट साईड इट इज फायनल फॉर्म इट इज रिटन इन अ फायनल फॉर्म ओके सो हाउ मेनी अल्फाबेट्स वी आर लर्न नाउ टुडे
11
सो आफ्टर झाइन इज से आफ्टर मी खेत
खेत खेत आफ्टर झाइन इज खेत एंड देन टेत
टेत
आफ्टर दैट टेत
टेत टेत
योर
योर
Cup.
Cup.
Cup. And this final form is called sophit. So say after me, cup sophit.
Cup sophit.
Cup sophit.
So these three letters, I will show you how to write. Can you see screen?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, I will show you. We have learned seventh alphabet, that is sign, correct?
Yeah.
Yes.
After sign is
Khet.
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 So Khet, Khet covers the whole box. Khet covers the whole box. What is different between Khet and He?
Khet and hay. There is gap between the
That is broken portion.
Yes.
This hay is having broken portion. Its transliteration is H, whereas for khet, transliteration is under S. There is a dot.
Yes.
Please note, observe this. Khet under H, there is a dot.
Dot.
Khet.
Then after Khet is which alphabet?
Tet.
Tet.
Tet. So please watch how to write Tet. This is spiral. Tet. Can I show you again? Start yes, from please. Upper left corner. This is
tet.
Again, its transliteration is under T. There is dot because there is one more alphabet which gives T sound. That is last alphabet tau. It also gives
tau.
It is 22 alphabet. Only difference between that alphabet is alphabet between khet and tau. It's here. There is one. Ledge, or you can say that inclined portion, so that will make Khet into Tau.
Tau.
But now only remember this Khet only. After Tet.
Yod.
Yod.
Now yod is very simple to write. It is. It takes only this portion. Bas. That's it. Yod.
Small.
Transliteration is Y.
Y.
Marathi madhe yo.
Yo.
T. S. K. Okay. Now I'll show you how to write kaf and kaf sufid. Now tell me which is this alphabet.
Zain.
This is that Dalit? Bet. No, not Dalit. The second one. Bet.
Bet. Very good. Bet. Now. Please observe the difference between this.
Yes.
Bet and Kaf.
Kaf. Oh.
This portion is right angle. This portion is curved.
Curve.
Yeah. So it is curvy. Now, when I put dot, it is clear K in kite. If I remove the dot, then it will be CH sound in bark. It gives kh sound. And when I write it at the end of the word, then it is kaf sofit.
Kaf sofit. Kaf sofit.
Kaf sofit.
See, it comes below the line, below the box. Kaf sofit chi ji line je ti box cha khali yeti. Hi lakshat ka.
Watch, you can say me again.
Pardon?
Yes, yes. B-S-E-H, watch. I can't understand the difference between watch and kaf.
Bet and kaf.
No, bet and kaf, not. That is.
Kaf and
T. Batch B-A-T, B-A-C-H.
B-A-C-H. Okay.
Bark.
See, this sound of this without dot of the kaf is very similar to khet. Khet sa sound ane without dot wala hazu kaf hai, hai sa sound same as that. Both sounds are same. But if I put dot in that, it will give clear K sound, like K.
Yes.
K.
So both are curved, but the one which is with dot is kaf, and without dot is bark.
Bark, yeah.
Okay.
And this sound is similar to this sound, keth. It also gives this K sound.
Yeah.
Okay, let's take revision. We have learned 11 alphabet. First is how to write Aleph. This is Beth. Then third is Gimel. Fourth is Dalit. After that,
Wow.
Hey.
Sorry.
Sixth alphabet is Wow.
Wow.
After Wow is
Zain.
Zain. Yeah. Then
Hey.
Khet.
Khet. After Khet is
Teth.
After teth is
yod.
And after yod is
kaf.
And we have learned kaf
sofit.
Okay, clear?
Yes.
So I once again welcome those who have joined 12:30. Sister Rebecca and Sister Manjushri. Actually, they have a problem. Their church is over by 12:30. So again, actually, as I told you, I have started this group, this batch only for this New Zealand people because their timing is very odd. And the timing जो आहे तो मी बाकीचे जे batches हैं ना त्यात minimum 8 ठेवलेली आहे 10 किंवा 15 लोक तरी पाहिजे minimum. खास त्यांच्यासाठी batch चालू केली आहे. तर you have to adjust something because already they have adjusted. त्यांनी जवळपास किती सहाची होती ती साडेसहा होती ना मागच्या वेळेस 6:30 होती तर 7:30 त्यांनी केलेलं आहे. तर एनिथिंग यू वॉन्ट टू से सिस्टर रिबिका और
फक्त चर्च 1 वाजेपर्यंत असत. अर्थात मी आले 12:30 पर्यंत मला बाहेर निघता आलं पण लोकांना मला कोणाला भेटता आलं नाही कोणासाठी प्रार्थना नाही करता आली त्याचं थोडस वाईट वाटलं. पण हिब्रू क्लास साठी मी मंजू मॅडम प्रवीणा मॅडम आणि सोनाली कुलकर्णी यांनी आम्ही सगळ्यांनी मिळून प्रार्थना केली होती उपास केले होते देवाकडे मागितलं होतं परमेश्वराने दिलेला.
तुम्ही व्हिडिओ ऑन करता का प्लीज वी वॉन्ट टू सी युअर फेस.
मी आता गाडीत बसले चर्च.
ओके नो प्रॉब्लेम.
आय एम सॉरी. आणि परमेश्वरानं खरंच आमची प्रार्थना ऐकली आणि त्याने उत्तर दिलं. काल मी तुमची टेस्टिमनी ऐकली आणि आय वॉज अमेझ. परमेश्वराचा स्पर्श मला जाणवत होता परमेश्वराचं सानिध्य मला जाणवत होत आणि देवापाणी मला स्पष्ट सांगितलं की मी ज्या व्यक्तीकडून तुला हे पवित्र ज्ञान देणार आहे ती व्यक्ती ही आहे. आणि मी देवाचे खरोखर खूप आभार मानते. परमेश्वर वचन देतो ते पूर्ण करतो तो प्रार्थनेचं उत्तर देणारा देवा आहे. हरकत नाहीये थोडस माझं मिस होईल पण मी ऍडजस्ट करेल.
बरं ठीक आहे. आपण एक काम करू शकतो याच्यात जर मार्ग काढायचा असेल तर जर नितीन आणि ब्रदर नितीन शिष्य सत्या थोडे फ्लेक्सिबल झाले आणि त्यांनी जर का 7:30 ऐवजी 8 जर केला तर आपण 45 मिनिटच सेशन घेऊ. आपण कारण तुमच्या इथं 8 o'clock होईल मला वाटतं जर स्टुडिओ 12:30 ठेवलं तर. ओके सो 12:30 आपण जास्ती असते त्याच्यामध्ये हे करू. ओनली फॉर यू पीपल मी त्यांना रिक्वेस्ट केलेली आहे तर 12:30 वर नका हे करू. एक तुम्ही चर्च सोडून प्रेयर करून 10-15 मिनिटांनी जरी जॉईन झाला तरी काय प्रॉब्लेम.
चालेल त्यांना प्रार्थना करून लोकांना भेटून जे टायमिंग त्यांना हे सुटेबल होईल.
थँक्यू थँक्यू ब्रदर.
फक्त त्यांना कसं नाईट त्यांची नाईट होती त्यांना जेवण करून वगैरे मग त्याला आपण हे नाही जास्त नाही करू शकत. आपण जास्त जास्त 12:30 पर्यंत घेऊ आपल्या इंडियन टाइम. थँक्यू
थँक्यू
आणि विल रिड्यूस द टाइम देन 45 मिनिट्स करू. सो नेक्स्ट अल्फाबेट इज Lamed is the biggest alphabet out of this 22 alphabet.
Biggest
and which is the smallest? Yod is the smallest alphabet, and this Lamed is the biggest alphabet. So Lamed gives L sound in look. L sound in look, like L.
L.
Look matlab L. L sound with Lamed. Lamed, the meaning of Lamed is to learn or to teach. Shika kiwa shikwa. Lamed also means ox, goat, that is bailache, nangar. And it also represent a shepherd's staff. Akri. See, can you see this pictograph language? It is like a shepherd's staff.
Shepherd's staff, yes.
It is a shepherd's staff. Then next alphabet is septami, mem.
Mem.
Actually, in pictograph, you can see it is like a wave. Wave of an ocean or that water wave. Paniyacha je lahari jayat, the pictograph language. Actually, the mem means water. Mem means water. Pani, sea, samudra, ocean, mahasagar. And it actually means a main, that is a wave, lot. It gives M sound.
M sound.
M sound in mom. Mom. Now, there are two at my left hand side, that is the consonant mem. That broken portion is there at the bottom. Khali je thoda broken portion, that is mem. And the closed portion is mem sofit.
Mem sofit.
Mem sofit. That is final form. There is shabda cha shevti litat. When that letter is written at the end of the word, that is called mem sofit.
Mem sofit.
Mem sofit. So how to write, I will show you. This is the printed version, and what I am showing you is the handwritten version, and you have to practice handwritten version. Tumcha yachyamadhye chapter 1 kiwa 2 madhye there are boxes given, empty boxes. So I will give you the separate sheet. You have to take the printout of that separate sheet, and whatever alphabet you have learned till this manje ajun ek don ghevu. Till there, you have to write it in the boxes. Boxes, you have to practice. Okay. Next alphabet is noon.
Noon.
And that line extended below is the noon sofit. Noon sofit.
Extended below. Okay. Noon sofit.
In pictograph language, you can see this like a sprouted seed.
Yes.
You know, right? Moog, kiwa matki.
Yeah.
The sprout. What do you mean? What do you mean? Mode.
Mode.
Mode. Mode. So that this is the sprouted seed. Sprouted seed. Pictograph language. It represents a new birth, life. New life. It means increase, offspring, santati, fish. It also means, noon means fish also. It also means sprouting seed, ankurlele beads.
Yes.
And its transliteration is N in now. N. It gives N sound, N. N.
N.
N.
Thank you.
So we have seen three alphabet, that is Lamed, after me, Lamed.
Lamed.
Mem, Mem Sofit.
Mem Sofit, yeah.
And Noon and Noon Sofit.
Noon and Noon Sofit.
Okay. So I will show you how to write this three alphabet.
That one with Sofit, four letters, letters there. With Sofit.
Sofit, na?
Khet Sofit, yeah.
Khet la na Sofit. Khet doesn't Sofit. Have Sofit.
No, Khet, not Kaf, sorry. Kaf Sofit, yeah? Kaf Sofit, yeah.
Kaf Sofit,
and which is the other one?
Non Sofit. Kaf Sofit, Mem Sofit, and Non Sofit.
Yeah. Names of it. Names of it.
Okay. So we have learned till which alphabet? Kaf and Kaf Sofit. After that, which alphabet we have learned?
Lamed.
The cup is Lamed. So how to write Lamed, please watch.
Joy.
How we can write Lamed. Start from left side. Then go to the upper top, come at the middle. Top right la jaycha and middle la Lamed. The line go above the box.
That line one is biggest letter.
Yeah, line go above the box. After Lamed, we have learned Mem.
Mem.
It is L sound. Mem. How to write Mem? See here. From here, start. And give little horn here. And you have to write this letter in a boxes only. There are square boxes in that only you have to write. I will provide you that PDF file of the empty boxes with name. And so now asli me box letter then.
What about that Lamed?
This is Lamed.
This one.
Mem.
It will go outside the box, right?
Only Lamed, the upper tail will go outside the box. Otherwise, yes. A mem will fit in the box. It will not go outside the box. Then mem Sofit.
Mem Sofit, all sides closed.
So this mem Sofit. Make sure that this portion and this portion, or you can say this portion, it is 90 degree. Otherwise, if you make this like this, then it is another alphabet, next alphabet, that is Samik.
Samik.
That is Samik, which we are going to learn. So make sure that this there is a right angle. This portion can be curvy.
Okay.
This portion can be curvy, but these are the right angle. This is a very proper. This both should be 90 degree. This is Mem Sophit. Sophit means final form.
Final form.
Final form. So we have learned Lamet, Mem, Mem Sophit, and next alphabet is
Noon.
Yeah, Noon covers only the right corner. This much. Noon. It gives hand sound. No. Use ham sound. And this is Noon. Sophit. Watch here, the line go below the box. This line go below the box. Next alphabet is Samik. Say after me.
Samik.
Make sure that there is a ledge. It is actually complete round, but this is a ledge. And the main distinguishing between this Mem Sophit and Samik, this is 90 degree over here, but this is curvy. This is curvy. Samik. It gives S sound. And one more alphabet I will teach today and then we'll finish. That is, say after me, Ain.
Ain.
This is Ain.
Ain. Like a light.
The Samik and Ain we have seen. Ain again, it is in transliteration, it is reverse apostrophe. There is a background noise coming, so please. After Noon, it's Samik. Just we have seen Samik. Say after me, Samik. Samik. It means support. It also means laying off an hand. Laying off a hand. And it also means thong. Apni kata muntu. Aadhar. हाथ ठेवणे किंवा काटा. नाउ इन पिक्चोग्राफ लैंग्वेज सी इट इज लाइक अ सपोर्ट. सपोर्ट कर्सिव मध्ये हा कंप्लीट ओ आहे. इट इज लाइक ओ. मेक श्योर दॅट देर इज अ लेज हियर. एंड सामिक इज एस साउंड इन एस. And next alphabet we have seen is Ain.
Ain.
Now from here starts the body parts. Ain means eye. In the picture graph language, it is a picture of an eye.
Eye.
And it is a silent letter, and in transliteration, it is reverse apostrophe. So what is the, which is another silent letter? Can anyone tell me? The first letter?
Aleph.
Aleph is a silent letter and transliteration is apostrophe. Whereas Ayn is also a silent letter and its transliteration is reverse apostrophe. Can you see here its transliteration? Reverse apostrophe. Although it is not included in silent letter. Technically, it is not a silent letter because if you see in ancient time, it was acting as it was giving a G sound. G. It was giving G sound. And it is very difficult to pronounce. There is a very huge ambiguity between this, how to pronounce this sound. Actually, it gives a G sound. For example, in ancient time, the word Gomorrah. So when two gutters come very close, that time the air, when it comes out, so that time at Google, so that Gomorrah, that sound, it gives this letter. So it is, although it is a silent letter, but it is not technically silent letter. It gives a G sound, Gomorrah. That therefore it will not come under the category of silent letter. The meaning is I, spring, fountain, knowledge, character, cleansing, purification. Archa, dola, karanje, nyan, charitra, sapkarne, shuddhikaran, ashebarashe, arthe. So Hebrew alphabets are very strange. The letter used for Hebrew alphabet is oth. Oth manje kay tar akshar, and the meaning of oth in Hebrew is signs and wonders. It is filled with signs and wonders. No other alphabet you will find that there is a numeric value also. This every Hebrew alphabet is having numeric value. For example, this ayin is 70, this samek is 60, noon is 50, mem 40, lamed 30, kaf 20, and yod 10. After 10, it is not 11, but 20. 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, and 70. We have seen till samek. There are more seven alphabet, which we have to learn. That seven alphabet, we will learn next time, and we'll finish this alphabet. And after that session, we'll start the vowel. हे जे सात राहिलेले अल्फाबेट आपण पुढच्या सेशन मध्ये घेऊ आणि वॉवल जे आहेत त्याच्या नंतरच्या सेशन मधून आपण चालू करू. टेक युअर टाइम टू प्रॅक्टिस दिस अल्फाबेट. तुमचा स्वतःचा वेळ खर्च करा आणि ती प्रॅक्टिस करा अल्फाबेटचे. आय विल सेंड टुडे द पीडीएफ फाईल, द एम्प्टी बॉक्सेस. यू टू जस्ट टेक प्रिंट, और if it is not feasible for you to take print, then do one thing, take that your children's that mathematic book, char lining chi the box che mathematic book asti na ti gya and tyachatna practice kara. Prepare a big box in that and at least practice five times, get familiar with this alphabets. Okay. So once again, we'll say this alphabet and we'll finish. Say after me, Aleph.
Aleph.
Everyone unmute yourself and say now, Aleph.
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 Beth.
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 Gimel.
Gimel.
Dalet.
Dalet.
Hey.
Hey.
Wow.
Wow.
Zain.
Zain.
Ket.
Tet.
Tet.
Yod.
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 Kaf.
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 Lamed.
Lamed.
Mem.
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 Noon.
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 Samek.
Samek.
Ayn.
Ayn.
Then pay. This alphabet we are going to see next time, but just say pay.
Pay
means mouth. Then sade.
Sade.
Kof.
Kof.
Resh.
Resh.
And last alphabet is Tau.
Tau.
Very fascinating Tau. Thing about this last alphabet. It's actually in pictographic language, it is like a cross sticks. The picture of this Tau is like a cross. Not like it is a, in ancient time it was written as a cross. So this remaining seven alphabet, next time I will show you how to write. And all about this seven alphabet we are going to look into. Just for 5 minutes, now we have learned this So last time I have shown you about the I am that I am. And in that, there was one slide which I told you that after learning the 10th alphabet, I will show you that slide. Now today, in just 5 minutes, I will show you this slide and we'll finish. Okay, see. Now, decoding of the great and the very great name, the personal name of our God, which in time past has lost its pronunciation. Baratsha lokanni tyacha je naav aahe tyacha kasa uchchar karayacha tes maahiti nahi. Because foreign deities are also call their name of their god as God. हे जे बाकीचे लोक आहेत ते पण गॉडच म्हणतात, लॉर्डच म्हणतात. सो व्हाट इज द पर्सनल नेम ऑफ अवर गॉड, आपल्या देवाचं वैयक्तिक नाव काय आहे आणि त्याचं डिकोडिंग काय, वी आर गोइंग टू सी. नाउ यू नो इन बीओबी ट्रान्सलेशन द पीपल से यहोवा. And Jehovah means the existing one, the proper name of the one and true God, unpronounced except with the vowel pointing of Adonai. Actually, there are four letters used for the pronunciation of the name of our God. आपल्या देवाचं नावाचा उच्चार करण्यासाठी चार हिब्रू चार अल्फाबेट वापरण्यात आले. व्हिच आर दॅट, से आफ्टर मी, योद.
Yod.
Hey.
Hey.
Wow.
Wow.
Hey.
Hey.
These are the four letters. So these are the four letters used for the pronunciation of the name of this very sacred God. Actually, the first syllable of this letter is Yah. In Psalm 48, it is given, praise him with his name Yah. The first syllable of the name of our God is Yah. And in Psalm 150 also we say Hallelujah, that Yah. So if first syllable is Yah, then how can it be Yehovah? Yehovah is a completely wrong name. It is there was a great chaos during, we can say, 5th or 6th century before Christ. Some Alexandrian Jews, they went to Egypt and they done the whole mess. What they did, they profaned the name of our God and they took this name Yahweh with, they attached it with other foreign deities, and thus they have profaned that name of our God. And then what happened, these some heretic Jews, they were not so devoted, but they made it rule and they made it compulsory to everyone that according to the third commandment, that you should not take the name of your God in vain. तू आपला देव परमेश्वर याचं नाव व्यर्थ घेऊ नको. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दॅट कमांडमेंट व्हॉट दे डिड, एव्हरी पर्सन, नो वन विल प्रनाउन्स दिस सेक्रेट नेम. कोणी या नावाचं प्रनाउन्सिएशन करणार नाही. दे विल नॉट प्रिंट ऑल्सो दॅट नेम इन मॅगझिन्स. मॅगझिन मध्ये देखील नाव प्रिंट करणार नाही. Because the magazines, newspaper, they can go into the dustbin. So they were very having reverence to this name. But some of the heretic Jews, they taken the advantage of this third commandment and they said never. Whereas in scripture, every time when they gather together, they used to praise this name. या नावाने ते स्तुती करायचे. नाव घेऊच नका असं सांगितलेलं नाहीये. बट सम ऑफ द ज्यूज दे मेड इट डिक्री, दे मेड इट कमांडमेंट दॅट डोंट टेक दिस नेम. त्यांनी असं जाहीर केलं की हे नाव घ्यायचंच नाही. सो फ्रॉम दॅट टाइम इन्स्टेड ऑफ दॅट दे टेक द नेम अदोनाय. सो इन मॉडर्न इस्रायल यू सी एव्हरीवेअर अदोनाय. अँड सम पीपल टेक, some Jew take the name as Hashem. Shem means name. Hashem means the name. They will take the name. Now what some of this Masoret, the group of people who put the vowel pointing in around 5th century to 10th century AD, what they did, actually this script was a consonantal text. It was the consonantal text, but this group of people, Masoret, they have accurately put this vowel pointing under it. Now they know what is the actual original pronunciation of that name. But because of the fear of Jews, what they did, they added the vowel pointings of Adonai. See here, it is given. The proper name of the one and true God, unpronounced, except with the vowel pointing of Adonai. They took the vowel pointing of Adonai and they attached this tetragrammaton name, that is Yod He Vav He. They mixed it and the word came is Yehovah. Jasa Moshe la te Aharona ni nahi ka, Aharona la lokanni sonu magitlan tyatna vasru alo. Tasha type cha he zala ki these Masoret people, they took this tetragrammaton name, four letter, and they put that vowel pointing of the Adonai and they mixed it together and the name is Yehovah. In Hindi Bible it is given Yehovah, but it is completely wrong name. The correct pronunciation of the name is Yahweh is the very accurate and the correct pronunciation of name, because the first syllable of the word Bible itself tells us that it is Yah. Praise Yah. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I have so many teachings that I have given in the churches regarding the name Yah. Yah Yahweh. Even Yahweh. And sometime when I'll get time, I will share you that slides. But the proper and correct pronunciation, which we can use, we have to rever this God in our prayers, personal prayers, in our praising time, while teaching your children, take the reverence of this name. You have to take this, you can take this name, Yahweh. Yeah, but don't take it in public places. Otherwise, that will create a chaos. And don't try to teach in your church also. Only use it for yourself. And when any person who is eager to know Hebrew, to them, you can tell this name. Because I'm telling this according to the scripture portion. So this is the tetragrammaton name. And many of our song is, we say Yehovah.
Yes.
This is my testimony when I came to know this proper name. Even people are saying Yehovah, I will say Yahweh and I will praise. Jari loka Yehovah manat asil tari ti mi Yahweh manun devachi kay karu stuti karu. Because if your name is Nitin and if I call you Avinash, he will not respond me. How can he respond me? You are Noten और त्याच्या नावाचं जर का वेगळंच नाव करून मी बोललो तर कसं काय ऐकणार. सिमिलर इट इज विथ द नेम, पर्सनल नेम ऑफ द वन अँड ट्रू गॉड, हिज नेम इज यावे. सो इन पिक्चोग्राफ लँग्वेज दिस योड इज वी आर लर्न हँड हँड. हे मॅन इज प्रेझिंग लो, हे मीन्स लो, लुक दिस मॅन इज प्रेझिंग गॉड. अँड वाव, दिस वाय शेप वाव मीन्स a tent peg for erecting the tabernacle. It represents the symbolizes the cross of Christ. Again, this man is praising God. So can you get the clue from this pictographic language? What could be the name? Yeah?
Behold the hand and behold the stuff.
Yeah, behold hand and behold nail. Now we will first calculate the numeric value of the one and true God, and to your astonishment it is 26. 6 is not devil's number, no, it's God's number. It is 26. Yod he wow hey, it is 26. We can also take the name of our God if you are very scared, or if you feel like it is a very sacred name that I should not take, you can say Yod He Wow He. Yod He Wow He He. Yod He Wow He. And throughout the Old Testament, Yahweh, the one and true God, is very eager to reveal his salvation to his people. The all 39 books, every chapter, every word in that book, God is very eager to reveal his Yeshua, salvation, to his people, because scripture speaks about the salvation and nothing else. Purna Pavitra Shastra madle 39 junya karatle pustak he tarna vishesh boltat, because in Old Testament time God was going to reveal the salvation, and from there, from then it will start a new covenant. Tar this salvation, the word salvation is hidden in Yahweh. In Yahweh. Yahweh, the meaning of Yahweh is Yeshua, is salvation. Yeshua hakaya tarnara.
Salvation.
Behold hand and behold nail. Hat paha, khila paha. Hat ko dekho, khile ko dekho. This man is saying, see what the God's hand has done. Yahweh's bhuj konala pragat zala. Isaiah 53. You know that scripture portion. Isaiah 53. Which tells us about the arm of God. Which tells us the arm of God. Behold, this man is looking to hand. And we see this. Another man is saying, look at the nail. And you know, the name Yahweh, around it comes, I think it comes 4,700 times in Bible. So whenever that name comes, when the name comes, the meaning of that name is salvation. Look at the salvation. Look what my hand has done. And you know Isaiah 53, who has believed our reports, and to whom is the arm of God revealed. And it speaks about, the whole chapter speaks about the Yeshua. For he grew up before him as a tender plant and as a root out of dry ground. He had no form nor comeliness, and when we shall see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. त्याला रूप नव्हते, त्याला रंग नव्हते, त्याच्याकडे पाहिले तर त्याच्यावर मन बसलं असतं, त्याची काही शोभा नव्हती. मनुष्याने टाकलेला, क्लेशांनी व्यापलेला, व्याधींशी परिचित असा तो पुरुष पाहून लोक तोंड फिरवीत. आपल्याला तो स्क्रिप्चर पोर्शन माहिती. सो येशुआ इज नथिंग बट द वर्क ऑफ गॉड्स हँड. व्हॉट इज द वर्क ऑफ गॉड्स हँड? नॉट फिल्ड विथ स्ट्रेंथ अँड पॉवर, बट हियर वी नो दॅट येशुआ, द किंग ऑफ किंग, वॉज ह्युमिलिटेड. And it, he was hanged between the heaven and earth. And that man, we got the salvation. We got the, we are the beneficiary of this salvation. आपल्याला तर तारणाशी आपण बेनिफिट बेनिफिट घेणारे लोक आहोत. अँड दिस मॅन वी दिस मॅन इज प्रेझिंग बिकॉज ऑफ व्हॉट द यावेस हँड हॅज डन. दिस मॅन इज प्रेझिंग बिकॉज व्हॉट ही हॅज डन ऑन द क्रॉस. त्या वधस्तंभावर जे केलेलं आहे ते दिस इज द डिकोडिंग ऑफ द नेम ऑफ अ गॉड यावे. सो रिमेंबर वेन एव्हर यू आर रीडिंग द स्क्रिप्चर यावे द लॉर्ड कॅपिटल लॉर्ड इन इंग्लिश एल ओ आर डी that is nothing but the word Yahweh in your Bible. And whenever you are reading that word Yahweh, that represents the work that his hand has done, and that work is nothing but Yeshua. May Yahweh Elohim bless you in Yeshua's name. Yeshua cha naavat to tumhala sarvanna aashirvadit karo. Okay. Sister Rebecca, can you lead us in closing prayer if it is comfortable with you? Okay, Praveena, join with Praveena. Can you
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit, O Lord Jesus. We praise you, we worship you, O Lord Jesus. We exalt your name, O Lord Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord, we submit ourselves in your mighty hand, O Lord Jesus. And whatever you have, you are providing us through Pastor, O Lord Jesus, bless him, O Lord Jesus. Bless each and every person, O Lord Jesus, who is attending this class, O Lord Jesus. Bless us, O Lord Jesus, and take charge of our memory, O Lord Jesus. Let us remember each and every word, O Lord Jesus, from this teaching, O Lord Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit, O Lord Jesus. You have spoken us with us through this class, O Lord Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. And let us spread your salvation, O Lord Jesus, throughout the world, O Lord Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit, O Lord Jesus. Take charge of ourselves, O Lord Jesus. Take charge of our mouth, O Lord Jesus. Bless us, O Lord Jesus. And we will spread your word, O Lord Jesus. We will spread your gospel throughout the world, O Lord Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Through this class, O Lord Jesus, whatever we are learning, O Lord Jesus, we will remember it and we will spread it in our in your people, O Lord Jesus. Yes, thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Provide that strength, O Lord Jesus. Provide that power, O Lord Jesus. Without you, we are nothing, O Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit, O Lord Jesus. You are the source of knowledge, O Lord Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit, O Lord Jesus. Again, we all pray together, O Lord Jesus. Bless Pastor, O Lord Jesus, and bless him, O Lord Jesus. We receive your blessings for them, for him, O Lord Jesus, because he is providing us this knowledge, O Lord Jesus. And thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit, O Lord Jesus. Bless our class, O Lord Jesus. Yes, Lord. In Jesus' precious name, we pray. Amen.
Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Pastor.
Yeah, I will teach you one word. Yahweh Evarekeka. Say after me.
Yahweh
Evarekeka means God bless you. Yahweh Evarekeka. God bless you in
English.
Actually, the Barak. Barak is the root word that means blessing. So Evarekeka means he will bless you. So Yahweh Evarekeka.
Yahweh Evarekeka. Yes. Thank you.
Chief. Okay.
Thank you, Pastor.
Thank you. Toda. And Laila, good night.
Oh,
Laila.